Good morning. Today we are going to discuss about indoor gardening. So gardening is a process of beautification the area, that is gardening. So in beautification we can use the trees, shrubs, vines and climbers, ground covers, seasonal plants for beautification of surrounding. But here important thing we are going to discuss about indoor gardening. We are not this focusing on the outdoor gardens. In other lectures mostly we discussed about the outdoor gardens, but today we are going to discuss about indoor gardening. Indoor, you see, in our houses, in our home, inside offices or any other indoor conditions. So what is the important thing in this? Still we were discussing about the ornamental plants. So you know, ornamental plants, trees, shrubs, ground covers, vines and climbers, seasonal plants, etc. So in this one we can say just we are going to discuss, or we can say in indoor gardening we normally grow the pot plants, or we can say the container gardens. So today we are going to discuss about indoor gardening in detail, and after the end of this lecture we will solve these some multiple choice questions in quiz. So be ready and try to pay your attention, because your questions will be from this topic. So indoor gardening, identifying ideal house plants having tropical and subtropical regions. So I mean, the for indoor gardening we should identify the ideal house plants or pot plants that having tropical and subtropical origins. So we can say this is the very important. So majority of house plants that are suitable for indoor gardening are from tropical and subtropical regions. So these plants are originated from tropical and subtropical zones. So plants from these warmer regions are ideal for indoor gardening because they can withstand many conditions that other plants cannot. So plants from these warmer regions are ideal for indoor gardening because they can withstand many conditions that other plants cannot. So we can say this one is also very important and potential question for the multiple choice questions. Ideal indoor gardening plants are, or we can say the suitable or ideal indoor gardening plants are from warmer regions. And reason because they can withstand many conditions that other plants cannot. So warmer condition plants are more hardy and they can tolerate the adverse climatic conditions too. Then next point is 90% of the 3 lakh plants species derived from the tropical and subtropical regions, leaving plenty of options, but there for the avoid indoor gardeners. So we can say 90% plants are suitable particularly in tropical and subtropical regions or indoor gardening. What makes a house plant a house plant? what makes a house plant a house plant. So what are the important things that makes suitable a house plant for indoor gardening? That is the important thing. And tolerates dry indoor air, can live indoors for prolonged 1 year or longer periods of time. So we can say these plants are tolerates dry indoor air in indoor gardening is reason because, for example, in living room or bedroom we are keeping the indoor plants. So when we use the or when we will turn on the ceiling fans, so that can create the dry indoor air. So these plants are, if these plants are susceptible to dry indoor air, then your plant will die. Or if your plants are hardy, then they can tolerate dry indoor air. So grows relatively fast, does not grow tall than ceiling heights. So it is also a very important if you are selecting any plant to grow in the containers or pots. So be careful, the height of that plant should not not taller than the ceiling heights. And easy to multiply, I mean the these indoor plants we can easily multiply by cuttings or by layerings or by air layerings or by any other mode of propagation. So it should be easy to multiply and require little pruning and pinching, because if these plants require growing the too fast, then require the too much pruning, pinching, etc. So we should try to select the indoor plants that require the little pruning and pinching. Then resistant to insects, insect pests or diseases can tolerate neglect, abuse. So I mean the indoor plants should be free from insect pests and diseases, and also have an ability to resistant against the insect pests and diseases. Because we are growing the indoor plants in inside area, so if more controlling of insect pests and diseases, if we are spraying the some insecticide, pesticides, that will be health hazardous. So does not require any bag breaking conditions. Yeah. Choosing plants based on personality. So choosing plants based on the personality. So we can say, as per your status, you can choose the indoor plants. Gung ho but lose interest. Gung ho but lose interest. Someone that is excited in the beginning of a project but grows uninterested. So if these categories you choose plants that do not need a lot of care, that will still look good once you begin to stay away. So this gardener should grow cacti, succulents and hardy foliage plants. So mostly in indoor conditions we grow the foliage beauty plants like aglaonema, Diefenbachia, and we can say the zebra plant, money plants, monstera. These type plants are suitable in indoor conditions. Or in case of the flowering plants, we can grow the anthurium too. But in case of the roses, that require the fully sunny environment, so we have to keep outside, or we can keep in the indoor, in windows that receive the maximum sunlight, then that plant can bloom. Okay, so we can say the in container gardenings or indoor, if we are growing the cacti, succulents, and hardy foliage plants that are xerophytic in nature are suitable. So, commonly used indoor plants are common name cast iron plant, and botanical name is Aspidistra elatoir. And this plant belongs to family Asparagaceae. So this one is the lovely foliage beauty plant and easy to multiply and very good. We can grow in the containers. Another important plant is donkey's tail, that is the Sedum morganianum, belongs to family Crassulaceae, and this one is the is very good plant in the category of succulents. It requires the minimum water, and this plant can grow well so in containers. So this plant you can grow in the outdoor as well as the indoor, and very easy to multiply, and requires the minimum moisture as well as the plant nutrients. Then golden ball cactus, botanical name of this plant is Echinocactus grusonii, belongs to family Cactaceae. So this one is the xerophytic plant and slow growing plant and very hardy. So this one also can grow at minimum moisture and minimum plant nutrients. So but this can become grow in the outdoors as well as the indoor. If you are growing in the indoor, then it can create the problem. So at weekly interval we have to keep in outside sunny areas. So easily forgets, gardeners has good intention but is easily distracted from their task. So sometimes gardeners has good intention but easily distracted from their task and they neglect to work. So gardeners should choose low maintenance plants that can tolerate droughts. So for indoor gardening, gardeners should choose the plants they require the low maintenance, because in high maintenance plants, unnecessarily maintenance cost will be high. And also gardeners should select the plants in addition to low maintenance, plants can tolerate the drought. Gardeners should grow the cacti and succulents, because cacti and succulents are very good, or we can say this suitable for indoor gardening. And other than these, we can select the plants from family Asparagaceae and also from the Ericaceae, family Ericaceae, because family Ericaceae plants require the high water, but it's very suitable for suitable to grow in the shade environment. So we can keep these plants in indoor environment for long time. So the following plants are great examples what you should grow. So arrow head plant, that is the Syngonium podophyllum, belongs to family Ericaceae. And this Syngonium podophyllum plant is also known as the money plant. So this plant, generally you have seen in indoor conditions, many people, they grow in the glass containers, bottles, etc., just only in water. So we can see in these plants, water requirement is high and also the set tolerant and very easy to multiply. So this plant have wonderful foliage beauty plants, so this is very much suitable for indoor gardening. Dumbkin, just before I gave you example of this dumbkin, this is the Diphenbachia species. So botanical name of dumbkin is Diphenbachia species, and this one is also belong to family Ericaceae, and this one is easy to multiply and very good plant for indoor gardening. And this one, they have some spotted dotates on the leaves, and leaves are chordate in we can say in oval shape, and is very lovely foliage beauty plant. So the name indicates dumkin. So if a juices of this dumkin plant are consumed by the children, then it can create the problem of dung. That's why name is dumkin. And jade plant, the botanical name of jade plant is Crassula argentina, and this one belongs to family Crassulaceae. And this one is the lovely plant of in the group of succulents. So their water requirement is low and very hardy plant, also the drought tolerant and easy to multiply. So this plant we can keep in the indoor as well as the outdoor, and very much suitable for containers or pot plants. So overly caring, this gardener prunes and picks at their plants constantly. And this is not such a bad thing if you have the right plants. So we have to select the right type plants we can grow in the indoor gardening. And major criteria, we should select the low maintenance plants. So the gardener should choose challenging plants, plants that thrive from pruning. So gardeners can also choose the challenging plants too. So they can thrive from the pruning. So, but these plants are under the category of high maintenance cost. So if the client afford the maintenance cost, then we can select the challenging plants too. So the following are plants that you as an overly caring gardener should grow. African violet. African violet plant, botanical name is Sempolia ionantha, and this one belongs to family Jasmeraceae, and this one is the flowering plant and easy to multiply. So if we are keeping in the indoor environment, then at weekly interval we have to keep in the outside sunny environment, so we can keep the health of the plant. And due to the sunlight, this plant will be in flowering stage. Second plant, the hibiscus, common name hibiscus, and also the China rose, and also can say the Sioux plant, and also we can say the goodale. So botanical name of this plant is Hibiscus rosaceensis, and this one is the lovely Serbi plant. So we can grow in the ground as well as we can grow in the pots. And this plant belongs to family Malvaceae, and this is the hardy and highly susceptible to jet seeds, or we can say the mealybugs. Those are these sucking time plants. And in this one is the nice green foliage as well as the variegated foliage, and bears the flowers round the year of various colors like red, pink, yellow, creamish white color, bicolor, and also the multicolor colors. So these plants can bloom round the year, and it's little hardy and very easy to propagate by, we can propagate by the stem cuttings too. Okay, so we can keep in the pots. And China doll, botanical name of this plant is Radar Machera sinensis, and this plant belongs to Bignoniaceae, and this one is also the flowering beauty plant, so we can keep outdoor as well as the indoor plants, and this one also easy to multiply. So the collector, so this gardener has to have one of the everything as a collector of plants. Look for miniature dwarf varieties so that you can fit more plants in a smaller areas. So we can say the collector, or those have hobby to collect the variety of plants. So in variety of plants, we should give the preference to miniatures and dwarf varieties. So in smaller area, we can accommodate the maximum number of plants. So we can, more plants can fit in a smaller area. That is the main criteria. So imagination or hobby of collectors is very important for this type indoor gardening. The following plants are great for the collectors. So in this one, number one, Amaryllis, botanical name is Hippeastrum species and belongs to family Amaryllidaceae. So this one is the shade loving plant and also bears the flowers. So very much suitable for indoor gardening. And Arthistar, botanical name of this plant is Cryptanthus species and belongs to family Bromeliaceae. So in Bromeliaceae, family Bromeliaceae is large number of genera and species available. And this one is the very hardy plant, and we can say the shade loving plant, and water requirement also we can say the moderate, and we can also easily propagate. And this one bears the beautiful spadix or spath, as well as the wonderful or lovely variegated foliage. So this plant have the flowering beauty as well as the foliage beauty, normally grown under the trees. Then flowering maple. So botanical name of this one is the Abutilon species, belongs to family Malvaceae, and this one is really suitable plant for indoor gardeners.
डॉक्टर नमस्कार।
नमस्कार, हाउ आर यू शिव कुमार? हाउ आर यू?
खैरिज भाई।
So generally used indoor plants, flowering maple. आवाज नहीं आ रही। Botanical name Abutilon species, and this one belongs to family Malvaceae. That is the gudal, or we can say the hibiscus plant. So this one is also we can propagate by the stem cuttings, and this one we can grow in the on the ground as well as the in containers. So this plant is also suitable for indoor gardening. Then bringing plants back indoors. So these are the main factors. So Follow the following steps to easily transition your plants back indoors. First, usually in the falls. So we can say the especially in temperate regions during the snowfall, so it can create the problems. So for this, bringing plants indoor before the temperature drops will allow the plants to adapt easier. So we can say during the snow, temperature goes in minus. So we should try to bring these type plants before temperature drops, before temperature goes down. Then caring, that is the related for maintenance. So clean up the plants, removing any dead leaves or flowers. Report plants if needed due to growth. So we can say this, sometimes in indoor plants, the leaves dry, or we can say the dead, or sometimes the if flowering plants, then flowers dry, dead. So these parts we should remove with the help of the scissors, and also we can treat with the some fungicides, etc. Okay, or if that plant requires the repotting, then we have to do repotting with a well mixture of the organic manures, etc. Then avoiding insects, so prevent bringing insects into the home by using pesticides. So pesticides can be replaced with soap and water in a spray bottle. Make sure you give plants a thorough rinse, letting them drain. Soap root ball in a diluted insecticide to kill soil insects. So we can say this, sometimes we can notice the insect pest infestation. So if you notice, then you have to bring outside that plant and you have to do treatment with the suitable pesticides to kill the all insect pests. And after treatment, and better you can try to use the organic ones. So in that one, very good example of mealybugs in a hibiscus. So we can mix the soap and water, and soap water we can spray with the spray bottles. So we can control at certain limits. Or also if you can notice the some problems of fungus as well as the insect pests in the soil, then also we can do, we can prepare the solution of insecticide and we can do the soil drenching to kill the insects. Then protect other household plants by quarantining plant brought in from outdoors. Quarantine for at least 40 days. Warning, disease and insects can spread from one plant to the next. So this one is the similar like at airports, seaports, we have the plant quarantine office. So when we bring the plant material from others, that is quarantine. So in case of the plants, we have to keep in the quarantine for at least 40 days. So in within 40 days, we can find out any insect pest or diseases. Or without plant quarantine, if we introduce these plants inside the house, then they can infect the other healthy plants. So plant quarantine is very important. And what is fertilizer? So fertilizing indoor plants that are moved outdoors require more fertilizer due to the varying weather conditions. And fertilizer is composed of many different nutrients that promote plants to grow. So in fertilizers, nitrogenous, phosphorus and potassium fertilizers we can use for the growth and development of indoor plants. So there are three main nutrients for plant growth that I mentioned: nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. Nitrogen vital to production of chlorophyll, and that is very important for photosynthesis. That helps produce new leaves and stems. And phosphorus vital in flowering and fruit bearing plants. Phosphorus provides bright colors and also increase the dry weight of the plants, and is very important for roots. So for roots growth and development, phosphorus is very important element or plant nutrient. Then third important macronutrient is potassium. It stores reserves and helps with resistance to insects and diseases. So we can say potassium in plant increase the disease resistance capacity. So it is also very important, and also important for fruiting plants. Choosing plants based on environmental conditions. So how much light? Indoor plants getting. So based on the light, three categories: sun loving plant, partial shade loving plant, and shade loving plant. So based on how much light is for windows. So window exposure is better. Plants will thrive. So it is also a very important parameters for indoor plants. Second, partial lit, that is the partial light. If you still don't know how much sunlight your room is receiving, you can perform a shadow test. So how to perform the shadow test? So in these are the some steps. Place a piece of white paper where you can to place a plant. Hold plant about 1 foot above the paper. Clear, darker shadow means you have full sunlight, and fuzzy shadow but can still see a figure means you have medium light, and faint shadow means the without being able to see a figure means so based on this asset gardening, and we can keep lighting signs of insufficient light signs or of excess lights. So weak elongated pale green growth, abnormally small leaves bending towards light, lack of bloom, or poor flowering, no growth, or slow growth, leaf, loss root, root rot, stem rot, wilting during the hottest hours of the day. So this lighting plays a significant role on indoor plants. So foliage curled downwards is a sign of burning. Brown, pale, translucent, yellowing, and thickening of new growth, compact and stunted growth due to poor light. And major signs of disease and distress: wobbly plants means that they are not well rooted, which can lead soil insects. Crowded roots plants should have a good root ball, but should not have excess root sowing. So in case of the crowded roots, we can do the root pruning, or we can divide that clump, and instead of the one plant, we can make the two plants, so we can reduce the number of roots. Unhealthy roots should be firm, not squishy. Also, tips of roots should be paler than rest of the roots. So this was the lovely presentation on on indoor gardening. And at the beginning of this topic, I told you at the end of this topic, we will discuss, we will solve the multiple choice questions in quiz. So this quiz have total 5 questions. Question number 1, what type plants can identify for ideal house plants having origin of? So option A, tropical region, option B, subtropical region, and option C, both tropical and subtropical region, D, none of both tropical and subtropical region. So in question number 1, correct answer is option C, both tropical and subtropical regions. Question number 2, generally plants from which region? Regions are ideal for indoor gardening because they can withstand many conditions. So option A, cooler, option B, warmer, option C, both cooler and warmer, and option D, none of both cooler and warmer. So in question number 2, correct option is B, warmer region. Then question number 3, how much percent of the plants species derived from the tropical and subtropical regions can use for indoor gardening? So in this question also we have 4 options. So option A, 60%, option B, 70%, and option C, 80%, and last option D, 90%. So in question number 3, correct answer is option B, 90%. So you can see these answers, you can tell it from the PowerPoint presentation of this lecture. Then question number 4, what is the botanical name of arrowhead plant? So option A, Syngonium podophyllum, option B, Colocasia esculenta, and option C, Crassula argentina, and option D, Centpolia ionantha. So in question number 4, correct answer of botanical name of arrowhead plant is Syngonium podophyllum. And now last question number 5, what makes a house plant can live indoors for prolonged 1 year or longer periods of time? So in this also we have 4 options. Option A, tolerates dry indoor air. Option B, intolerant dry indoor air. And option C, high water requirement. And option D, none of these. So in question number 5, correct answer is option A, tolerates dry indoor air. So this was the beautiful presentation on indoor gardening. So I hope you enjoyed this. Thanks. Good morning to all of you. Today I am going to discuss the use of color schemes in garden designing, or we can say use of the color schemes
in landscaping or landscape design. So we can say colors plays very important role. Colors plays the vital role in garden designing, because in garden designing, aesthetic value is the prime objective to develop the gardens. Or in landscaping, until the that area not appealing the attraction of the visitors, then our objective is never fulfilled. So we can say in the garden, we planting the ornamental plants that blooms beautiful flowers, various colors flowers, red, pink color, yellow color, orange color, mauve colors, purplish colors, white, creamy white color, bicolors, and even the some multicolors. And also these not only beautiful flowers but ornamental plants also have the beautiful foliage. Here I would like to give you examples of, if you have seen crotons, if you have seen acalyphas, also if you know variegated ficus, so various kinds, and even the, if you know the alternanthra, irisine, so these plants have the colorful foliage. So in ornamental plants, plants have beautiful flowers, beautiful foliage, and also those plants, they have beautiful foliage as well as the beautiful flowers. Also the plants have a beautiful canopy, architectural stem or tree trunk, or also the some plants bears the very attractive colorful berries or fruits. So they add the beauty of